21. The Young's modulus E for the first step and third step is the same as the material is same, that is 200 gigapascal. On the Young's modulus for middle step, that is E2, is 70 gigapascal. Now the conversion of 1 gigapascal into the megapascal is 1 gigapascal equal to 10^3 megapascal. The length of each step is given, that is 100 mm. Now in FEA we have to model this problem as a FEA model. There are 3 steps, so we say the each step has a 1 element with node RJ. For first step, element number 1 with IJ node as 1, 2. For second step, so element number 2 with node IJ as 2, 3. And element number 3 with node IJ as 3, 4. So first stage is the pre-processing. We have to divide this problem into the elements. So we have divided this problem into 3 elements with IJ nodes. So for first element, IJ node is 1, 2. For second element, the IJ node is 2, 3. For third element, the RJ node is 3, 4. The area of each cross section is given for first element, second and third. That is 14, 20 and 14. The length of each element is 100 mm. Young's modulus is converted into the megapascal. That is for first element is 200 into 10 to the 3. For second element, it is 70 into 10 to the 3. And for third element, it is 200 into 10 to the 3. So for our calculation, we require to calculate the AE divided by L to calculate the stiffness matrix. So AE upon L for first element will be, after calculating, will be 18 to 10 to the 3 newton per mm. For second element, it is 14 into 10 to the 3 newton per mm. And for third element, it is 18 into 10 to the 3 newton per mm. So this is structural problem. That means the approximation function for this structural problem, for this displacement problem, is first equal to A into U, where F is the force, K is the stiffness, and U is the deflection. So K in step bar, we can calculate K as AE divided by L, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. So for K1, it will be A1 E1 divided by L1 into matrix 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. Similarly, K2 and K3. So we have calculated the AE upon L for first element, second element and third element. So K1, we put the value of AE1 divided by L1, that is 80 into 10 to the 3. So we will multiply 80 inside this matrix and we keep 10 to the 3, which is common in 3 elements, as outside. So after multiplication, the first stiffness matrix K1 will be 80 minus 80 minus 80, 80. Now this element belongs to node IJ as 1, 2. So column number will be 1, 2 and row number 1, 2. Similarly, for second element, K2 stiffness matrix, K2 equal to A2, A2 divided by L2. Now, A2, A2 divided by L2 for second element is 14 into 10 to minus 3. So, we will multiply 14 inside the matrix, that will give 14 minus 14, minus 14, 14, and 10 to 3, we will keep outside the matrix as a common. Now, this second element belongs to IJ node as 2, 3. So, the column number and row number for the K2 matrix will be column number 2, 3, row number 2. Similarly, for the third element, K3 will be calculated as A3 divided by L3 into matrix 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. So, A3 divided by L3 will be 80 into 10 to the 3 that we have calculated. So, we will multiply by 80 inside the matrix and 10 to the 3 will keep outside the matrix. So, this matrix will be 80 minus 80 minus 80, 80. The column number row number will be 3, 4 as this element 3 belongs to node IJ as a 3 and 4. So this is the element stiffness matrix. We require to calculate the global matrix. So global matrix K will be what? The addition of K1 matrix, K2 matrix and K3 matrix. So this is the formation of global matrix. Global matrix will be what? Addition of all these three elements matrix. So first element matrix, that is the stiffness matrix, is at the location of column number 1, 2, row number 1, 2. K2 matrix, location of K2 matrix will be column number 2, 3, row number 2, 3. Similarly, K3 matrix is the location of the K3 matrix, the column number 3, 4, row number 3, 4. We will put these elements at the required position. In global matrix, the global matrix will be of size 4 by 4 because the problem has 4 nodes and 1 dimensional problem. So, first matrix we will put at the location of column number 1, 2, row number 1, 2, that is 80 minus 80 minus 80, 80. The second matrix will be at the location of column number 2, 3, row number 2, 3. that is 14 minus 14 minus 14 plus 14. Now this 14 and this 18 will be coincide to add the location number column number 2, row number 2. So they will be added to each other. Similarly, the stiffness factor of third element will be put at the location column number 34, row number 34. So 80 minus 80 minus 80, 80. Now this 14 and this 80 will coincide at the same location, that is the column number 3, row number 3. Okay, so they will be added to each other. 10 raised to 3 is among the common in all the three elements. So we keep this as outside the matrix. Now what is the global equation? Global equation is what? Force matrix is equal to stiffness matrix into deflection matrix. So what is force matrix? There are four nodes. So the force at node 1, F1, F2, F3 and F4 for second, third and fourth node. The K, that is the global matrix that we have calculated here. This will be 10 raised to 3 outside. The matrix will be 80 minus 80 minus 80, 94 minus 14, 0, 0 minus 14, 94 minus 80, 0, 0 minus 80, 80. And displacement matrix. Displacement matrix, that is the U1, U2, U3 and U4. Now we will put the boundary condition. Now what are the boundary conditions given in the problem? That is the first and fourth node is fixed. That means this first and this fourth node is fixed. So the displacement at first node and fourth node will be 0. Because there is no displacement, it is a fixed. And force is applied at this third node of value 75 kN. We will put this boundary condition. That means displacement at first and fourth node U1, U4 equal to 0. Now at the F1, F2 there is a no force. At the F1, there will be reaction force R1. F3 is given 75 kN in Newton, we can convert it into Newton. That is 75 into 10 to 3 Newton. F4, that is the reaction force R4. We will put this boundary condition in this global equation. So the global equation will be now F1 is R1, F2 is not given, that is 0, F3 75 into 10 to 3 and F4 as R4. Stiffness matrix is that we have calculated here and the displacement matrix. Now U1 and U4 is 0 because it is fixed end. So U1 0, U4 0. Now from this matrix you can form the four simple mathematical expression or the equations. And by solving this equation we will get the answer of U2 and U3. Okay. So first equation will be R1 equal to first row into this displacement column. Remember that in every equation you have to take this 10 raised to minus 3 outside the bracket. So R1 equal to minus 80, U2 10 raised to 3, equation number 1. Second equation, that is 0 equal to this minus 80 into 0, 0, 94 U2 minus 14 U3 into 10 raised to 3 equal to 0. That is second equation. Third equation, 75 into 10 raised to 3 equal to minus 14 U2 plus 94 U3 into 10 raised to 3, that is equation number 3. And R4 is equal to minus 80 into U3 into 10 raised to 3, that is equation number 4. Now to solve this equation, we will solve the equation number 2 and 3. So equation 2 into 94 and equation number 3 into 14 will solve in this way, so that we will reduce the term to U2. So while solving this equation, we will get the U2 as 1050 divided by 8640. That is U2 is what? 0.1215 mm. So after getting U2, we will calculate the U3. U3 is what? U3 is given as calculated from the U2, 0.816 mm. So these are the displacement of second and third node. Now we can calculate the R1 and R4 by putting the U2 and U3. So R1 will be what? Minus 9.72 into 10 to 3. R4 is minus 65.28 into 10 to 3. Now from this information, you can calculate the stress and strain in the element 1, 2, 3. Strain, we can know that it is the deformation divided by original length. So deformation of first element, that is here. It is the net displacement minus U1 plus U2 divided by the original length of first element, that is 100. For second element, strain can be calculated as a minus U2 plus U3 divided by original length 100. For third element, minus U3 plus U4 divided by length L3. In this way, we can calculate the strain in the first element, second element and third element. Why? After calculation, we will get the epsilon 1, that is stress in first element, that is 1.215 into 10 raised to minus 3. really epsilon 2 is 6.95 into 10 to minus 3. And epsilon 3, that is a minus 8.16 into 10 to minus 3. So from this strain, you can calculate the sigma, that is stress in the first element, second and third. So stress is what? It is E into epsilon as per the Hooke's law. So sigma 1 stress in first element will be E1 epsilon 1. It's 200 into 10 to 3 minus 1.215 into 10 to minus 3. That will be 243 Newton per mm square. Similarly, stress in the second bar, second element will be E2 epsilon 2, that is a 70 to 10 to 3 into 6.95 10 to minus 3, that is 486.15 Newton per mm square. And epsilon 3, that is stress in the third element, this is E3 epsilon 3. This will be 200 into 10 to 3 into minus 8.16 into 10 to 3. That calculation will be minus 1682 Newton per mm square. You can calculate this theoretically also, that is force upon area. The stress is nothing but force upon area. Okay. This is about the stepped bar using finite element analysis. These are the list of results. Thank you. Now we can solve this problem using ANSYS APDL. Okay. We will solve this problem in ANSYS APDL. So in ANSYS APDL we solve this problem. First we select type of problem in the preference. The preference is a structural problem because of force displacement. In pre-processing, we select the element type, add, edit, which is the stepped bar. So in link element, we select predefined it. Okay. We select the element. Then in material property, we will choose there are two different materials. So we choose the two materials. In material properties, material models. The material is structural, it is a linear element, elastic, and it is isotropic. It is what? For first material, it is 200 into 10 to the 3, that is 3. And Poisson's ratio will be 0.8. Similarly, material number 2, for second material, linear, elastic, isotropic. Given modulus is what? 0.72. Poisson's ratio as let's take this as 0.1. Okay. In sections, we have to define the cross section of each element. Then link, add. The first section, okay. First element, that is a section name. Hence, the first section. Link area is what? Now this first link is the same for the third element as well. Now second element. Second element, link area is also. We will define the three links. For the third element, the link area is also. We will model this problem now. Modeling, create nodes in FTCS. So there are what? 4 nodes are there. So first node will take at the x0, y0, z0. Second node, the length of second node from the first is 100. X is 100. Y and z will be 0 because this is one dimensional along the x direction problem. Third node will be 100 plus 100, that is 200, x will be 200, y 0, z 0. Third node, fourth node, 300 plus 100 plus 100, that is 300. These are the four nodes are created. Now we will define the element. For element, now for each element the cross section area is different. That is the we define the sections 1, 2, 3 for each element. We will go to the element attribute and we will define the set number. So here we will define the element number. So there are two kind of the elements, 1 and 2. Here are the sections, section number 1, 2 and 3. So we will take the first material and the section number 1. We will draw the element number 1 with nodes 1, 2. And for second element, the section will be section number 2 and material number 2 with the different material property, N1Z and the concentration. The second element will be with the node 2, 3. For third node, the material is number 1, same material of the first and third element, and section number will be 3. Third element with node 3, so you can draw. This is the modeling, that is the FA model of the problem. Now we have to apply the boundary condition. The boundary condition are what? The first and fourth node is fixed, and forces of 75 kN is applied at the third node. So in loads, we will go define loads, apply structural displacement. Displacement on node. First node and fourth node is fixed. So we have selected first and fourth. Okay. All day means all kind of displacement will be zero. We have fixed first and fourth node, that is first boundary condition. Second boundary condition is to apply the force at the third node. The force at the third node. This positive x direction, hence it is a fx. It is of 75 kilonewton, that is 75,000. So we apply the boundary conditions. This is the boundary condition number 2, that is the force applied at the terminal. We will solve this problem, solve current flow 6. We will get the solution is done, that is the problem is solved. We will see the result in the general post processing release results node of solution. We have solution, that is displacement along x, that is x component of displacement. Okay. So this is the displacement. First and fourth node is the zero displacement. For second, it is 0.1215, and for third, 0.815 m. Okay, so this is the displacement. We can see, we can plot the result into the plot result, deform shape, deform plus undeform. We can see the deform and undeform shape. Later we can see the contour plot of this problem, nodal solution, unit solution. This is contour plot. So this particular shows the intensity of displacement at the point. So the forces are applied at the third node, hence it is a red, that is the maximum displacement is there. And first node and fourth node is fixed, that is zero displacement, and the minimum displacement shown by red color. And the intensity is given by different colors values. We can do the animation of this to study the behavior of the displacement. So, deform here. You will see the deformation in this way. I hope you understand this problem.